What is up, sisters and misters? It is me, Mr. Junior, and I am back to do a video that has been long overdue. So I'm here to show you guys how to breed a 100% Pixelmon with the new Minecraft breeding method, the daycare blocks. So we're going to go ahead and jump straight into this video. The very first thing that we're going to want to do is determine what Pokemon it is that we're going to be trying to breed. So for this video, I'm going to try to choose a Charmander, and we're going to breed a 100% perfect Charmander. Since I'm going to be using Charmander as the Pokemon that I'm going to be breeding 100% of, I need to get out here and catch a bunch of Charmander. So I'm in a mountainous area because Charmander spawns in a mountainous area during the day with a very rare chance. So I just encountered one. I'm going to get out here and I'm going to try to catch him. And then we're just going to catch as many Charmander as possible because we're going to need a lot so that we can easily breed a 100%. Boom, caught that Charmander. You're going to repeat that step until you catch a lot of Charmander. If you're not sure of where the Pokemon spawns, you can always type wiki and the name of the Pokemon and it'll tell you. So here's some of Charmander's stats. So the abilities it can have are Blaze and Solar Power, which Solar Power is the hidden ability. Its gender rate is 87.5% male, 12.5% female. What that means is when you encounter a Pokemon, 87.5% of the time, the Charmander has a chance of being a male and a 12.5% chance of it being a female. Same as whenever it has an egg and hatches. It'll 87.5% of the time be a male and 12.5% of the time be a female. For spawning, if you click spawning, you can see here time, day, weather, clear in mountainous areas, and it is a very rare occurrence. So after you find your Pokemon that you're trying to breed, go catch a bunch of them and then proceed on with the next step. The next thing that we are going to determine is the size that we want for our Pokemon. There are 9 total sizes that you can get in Pixelmon, but 7 of them are able to occur naturally in the wild, and 2 of them are exclusively from breeding. Whenever you breed these Pokemon, you can have the chance of getting the smallest size, which is microscopic, and the largest size, which is ginormous. So if you look here, here's the chart of all 9 sizes. We have microscopic, pygmy, runt, small, ordinary, huge, giant, enormous, and ginormous. Now the 2 exclusive to breeding sizes are microscopic and ginormous, and I will explain how you guys can get those. So whenever you're breeding, how size is determined for the offspring is, it'll take the size of the Pokemon that you're breeding, average it out, and then it has a chance to be the size below it or the size above it. So say for example, if we have 2 ordinary Pokemon, it'll take the size below it, which is small, the size above it, which is huge, and it has a 1 out of 3 chance of being small, ordinary, or huge. But if we were to take something like a runt or a giant, it'll average out their size, so it'll be ordinary, and again, it would choose the one above it and below it, and it'll have a 1 out of 3 chance of being any of those sizes. In order to get a microscopic Pokemon, what you're going to want to do is get 2 pygmy Pokemon and breed them, and you have a 1 out of 3 chance of it being microscopic. Same for ginormous. If you take 2 enormous Pokemon and breed them, there is a 1 out of 3 chance that that enormous Pokemon will breed a ginormous offspring. Now that we have the size that we want determined, the next thing that we're going to do is look into the nature of the Pokemon that we want. What natures do is they will increase one stat and decrease another. So if you take a look here, we have 24 natures on screen. Natures that increase attack, lower defense, increase defense, lower attack, and then you have a few that are just kind of grayed out, being the hardy, docile, serious, bashful, and quirky. Now those actually don't do nothing. What they do is, for Quirky, for example, what it will do is it increases special attack, but it also decreases special attack. So there's actually no stat change that occurs because the stat that's affected is the same exact stat. So what you need to do is determine what stat is going to be best for the Pokemon that you're trying to breed. So for Charmander or Charizard, because that's who is going to be at the end of the breeding process and whenever we fully evolve him, the best nature that you can possibly get is either minus attack for special attack or minus attack for speed. So if we take a look at it, our increased stat is going to be special attack, and the decreased stat on the right is going to be attack. So we either want modest if we want a Charizard that's going to hit harder, or we're going to want a Charizard that has increased speed and lower attack stat, which is timid. So we're going to look to either have a timid or a modest Charizard. And I'm going to choose timid because I would rather the Charizard I have being faster than stronger because he already hits really hard. So the next thing we're going to want to look into is the ball type. And what I mean by ball type is if you take a look at the left-hand side of my screen where the Smeargle is, you can see that there's a red lid and a white base. And you can actually change that with breeding. So how that works is if you're breeding the same species Pokemon, so a Smeargle and a Smeargle for say, it'll be a 50% chance of being the mother or the father's Pokeball. So if the mother has an Ultra Ball, the father has a Pokeball, it'll be a 50% chance of being either of their Pokeballs. Now if you're doing different species such as like a Smeargle and another Pokemon from the field group like a Zigzagoon for example, then it would be 100% of the time the mother's ball, unless it is a master ball or a cherish ball, because those balls cannot be passed down upon breeding, so that would become just a standard Pokeball again. So the next thing that you want to look at is genderless. So when you're doing genderless breeding, it'll always take the Pokeball of the Pokemon in the right slot. And what I mean by that is if we look into the daycare block right here, there's two slots, and it'll always pick the Pokeball of the Pokemon in the right slot for it to pass down. So now that you know how to go about getting the right ball, we can move on to the next step. The final thing we're going to want to take a look at when breeding our 100% perfect Pixelmon is the abilities. Is there a specific ability you want? Is there a hidden ability you want? Well, how you can get them is, if it is a normal ability, if you breed same species Pokemon together, so two Charmander, the mother has an 80% chance of passing her normal ability down to the offspring. The father plays no part, unless the father is bred with a genderless Pokemon like a Ditto. So the father has a 60% chance of passing a normal ability on to the Ditto. And then if it is a hidden ability, the mother has a 60% chance of passing on the hidden ability to its offspring. And the father only plays a part if it's genderless breeding like with a Ditto, where it'll be a 60% chance also. The last thing I want to talk about before actually breaking down how we can breed these Pokemon are the six stats and what they mean. So the six stats are as follows. We have HP, attack, defense, special attack, special defense, and speed. So HP is hit points or health points, and that directly correlates with how much health your Pokemon will have. So the higher the IV for its health or its HP, the more HP your Pokemon will have overall. Then we have attack. What attack does is it plays a part in how strong your Pokemon's physical attacks are. So a physical attack would be something like Mach Punch or a Snorlax using Heavy Slam. That is physical. That is Pokemon on Pokemon contact. So that plays a part in the damage, that physical damage dealt. Defense is how well a Pokemon will defend against that physical damage. Then you have special attack. Special attack would be magic damage, something like Charizard's Flamethrower, because that is not a physical attack. Also, something like Confusion or Mind Blast. Those would all be considered special attacks. And then special defense is how well that Pokemon will defend against that special attack. And then speed. Speed is what determines which Pokemon will attack first. The fastest Pokemon will attack first. One of the last things that I want to explain before we move into actually breeding the Pixelmon is how the IVs work or how they can pass down. So of the two parent Pokemon, you have 12 IVs total between the two being 6 on each parent. So when you're breeding the Pokemon, those parents have a chance to pass down up to 3 of their IVs to the offspring Pokemon. Whenever you're doing that, you can use these power items such as the power weight, the power bracer, the power belt, the power lens, the power band, and the power anklet to guarantee that of these 6 stats, the corresponding power item will pass down that specific IV, so that whenever the 3 get passed down, or the chance of the 3 get passed down, one of them will guaranteed be the IV that the power item is attached to. Then we have the Destiny Knot. What the Destiny Knot does is between the 12 IVs that the parents have, it allows for up to 5 of the IVs to be passed down from the parents to the offspring. And a lot of people will pair the Destiny Knot with the power items, thinking that what that'll do is that'll make it to where 6 IVs get passed down. But that's not how it works. What actually happens is you have up to 5 IVs that can be passed down between the parents, and the power item just makes it to where that specific stat will get passed down so that the other 4 stats will be random. Another item that we have here for breeding is the Everstone. What the Everstone does is it'll guarantee the nature of whatever Pokemon is holding it gets passed down to the offspring. What it also can do is if you're breeding regional forms, it'll allow the regional form to be passed down to the offspring as well. The last thing that we have, and this doesn't necessarily have to do with breeding, but it does have to do with the daycare block, which is why I'm including it, is the Mirror Herb. What the Mirror Herb does, if you have a Pokemon that has an empty move slot, you can teach it one of the partner's egg moves. So for example, if we were to take a look in here, there's two slots. If this Charmander had an empty move slot and this Charmander had an egg move, if we used the mirror herb on this Charmander, it would teach us one of this Charmander's egg moves.
All right, we are almost ready to breed a 100% Pixelmon, but first, the last thing I want to give a little bit of information on is how you can increase your shiny odds to get a shiny bred Pokemon. So what I mean by that is you can do different things to help increase your shiny odds. So you can have different original trainers. So what I mean by that is if you have, like, the male Pokemon is your Pokemon and the female Pokemon is another person's Pokemon, that increases the odds that the offspring will be shiny by 6%. Well, six times, I guess, but which is significantly higher. Then you also have the shiny charm, which in order to get the shiny charm, you need to complete the entire Pokedex. So that's no easy task, but that'll increase it additional three times. So something that you can do to help increase your odds by doing the different original trainers, if you're breeding, get one of your friends or somebody to hatch the egg and then give it back to you, because if they hatch it, it'll be considered their Pokemon. And then if they trade it back to you, they're different trainers. So it'll increase the shiny odds of the Pokemon that you're trying to breed by six times. But if you combine both of those together, you have a 0.44% chance of being shiny, which is significantly higher than the normal base odds of like 1 in 8,000 something. But now that we went over all that, we can finally get into breeding the Pixelmon. Okay, now that we're ready to breed some Pixelmon, there's going to be two things that we're going to need to make this entire thing easier. The first thing is going to be a PC. So in order to make a PC, this would be the recipe. So we have 6 aluminum ingots, we have some redstone, then we have a lantern and a glass pane. So you're going to want to combine them in that order and you're going to get your PC. So you're going to use your PC to access all the Pokemon that you've caught so you can swap in and out the Pokemon that you're going to need to breed. And then the next thing that we're going to need is a daycare block. So you cannot craft a daycare block. You have to find them. So I will show you how you can find them.
In order to find a daycare block, what you're going to want to do is try to find a village. When you find a village, there's a chance that it says on the Pixelmon Wiki, the shopkeeper can sell it. So I don't see any in that shopkeeper. Don't see any in this shopkeeper either. But the wiki says that there's a chance that they'll sell it. So another thing you can look for are these daycare houses. So they look like windmills, and whenever you go to the daycare, there will be 3 different locations in which you can find a daycare block. So if we go up here to the front, this is the front, so the entrance, there will be a daycare right off to the side here. Then if we go towards the back, there will be one right here, and then there will be another one off on this side. So you have a chance of getting 3 different daycares. And then you'll use these daycares to breed your Pixelmon.
Okay, finally, after telling you guys 20 times that we're ready to breed a 100% perfect IV Pixelmon, we are actually ready to breed a 100% perfect IV Pixelmon. So we have our PC, we have our daycare block, and we have everything else that we need. So now what we're going to do is we're going to look through all these Charmander that we caught, and we're going to be looking for each of the following that we are interested in. So we're going to be looking for a Charmander with the size that we're interested in, which is enormous. We're going to be looking for a Charmander with the nature that we're interested in, which is timid. We're going to be looking for the ball type, which is a Pokeball. We're going to be looking for the hidden ability, which is solar power. And we're going to be looking for one that has each of the following stats. So we're going to be looking for one that has HP, attack, defense, special attack, special defense, and speed. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this open, and we're going to look through and see what these Pokemon have. So you're just going to use the commands IVs to look through to see if any of them have perfect IVs. And then you have one that's got perfect special defense, for example. So I'm going to put perf special defense. I'm going to rename it. So now I know that that one has perfect special defense. Some other things that we're also going to look at is their nature, their size, and then their ability. So if I click through, here's one that's timid, so I can name this one timid for the nature. Small, ordinary. This one's enormous, so I can name this one. Let's do size. Size is a little bit easier. So we have size. So what you're going to do is you're going to set these aside. So we have one perfect special defense, one that's timid, and one that's the size that we want. So we're going to continue looking through all these Charmander until we find all the spaces that we're looking for. Ooh, not those guys. So these ones are going to go back in here, and we're just going to grab the next Charmander, and we're going to keep on looking. All right, so after having some technical issues, I'm back, and I got all the Charmander that I need. So I have a Charmander for each IV that I need. So I have HP, Attack, Defense, Special Attack, Special Defense, and Speed. And I also have the hidden ability. I have Timid for my nature. I have two, one male and one female, just in case I were to need, you know, additional genders. And then I have Enormous, which is going to be the size that I'm trying to be getting for my, you know, Pokemon. So the first thing I'm going to want to do is work on the hidden ability. And since the hidden ability I have is on a male cannot pass down the hidden ability whenever you're breeding the same species Pokemon. So we have to get this hidden ability on a female, which in order to do that, we're going to have to breed with Ditto. And in order to do that, we're going to throw these bad boys right here into the daycare. And then that's where these things here, such as these hourglasses, come into play. So there are four different hourglasses. So we have bronze, we have silver, we have gold, and we have diamond. And in order to get these bad boys, you fight bosses, find them in chests, and stuff like that. So the copper, my apologies, I called it bronze. So the copper skips a single requirement for a Pokemon in the daycare. So what that means is if we put these bad boys up here, you'll see it says there are six different requirements that you have to meet in order for it to start producing an egg. So it'll skip one of those six requirements, and you'll be able to proceed on with your egg. So then we have the silver hourglass, which what that does is whenever you finish all the requirements, it'll start the breeding process, and it takes around 45 minutes, I believe, to finish an egg cycle. So if you use the silver hourglass on it, it'll reduce the time by 25%. Then we have these gold hourglasses that complete all the requirements and skip the timers, so it instantly creates an egg. And then the last one we have over here is this diamond one. So this diamond one's pretty crazy. So if we take a look, what this diamond one does is it completes all requirements and timers for all three of the daycare boxes, giving them perfect IVs, maximum happiness, and a ribbon. So that one is actually one that you can only attain from cheating or by like spawning it in, because it's only available in like creative or force spawning it in. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to use a bunch of these gold ones. And how you use them is you just pick them up and you left click them on the block and it'll create the egg. So now we have to hatch these eggs and try to get a female. All right, after about 20 different eggs, we finally got a female. So let's go ahead and check it real quick. And it doesn't have the hidden ability. Oh my goodness. So we're going to keep going until we can get a female with a hidden ability. All right. After like almost 30 attempts, we got another female. And boom, she finally has solar power. So now we're going to go ahead and name her hidden ability, because she now has the hidden ability that we want. So we can go ahead and put this Ditto and this male away. So the next thing that we're going to want to do is we're going to go ahead and breed her with this male that has the timid nature, so we can get hidden ability with the nature that we want. So what we're going to need is this Everstone. So we're going to take this Everstone, we're going to put this Everstone on the Pokemon with the nature, and then we're going to breed these two, the male and the female, and we should hopefully be able to pop out an egg that has the hidden ability and the nature. All right, the thing is the two Pokemon that we're currently breeding is the Timid and the Hidden Ability. So we're going to want to try to get a female, because the Pokemon that I have to breed for the size is a male. So we're going to need a female to be able to breed with this male so that we can get the combination that we're needing. So I had a male, so I got rid of it, and we're going to need to try a few more times. Hopefully we can get it within a few tries, and we need to get a female with the Hidden Ability. Okay, after like 30 more attempts, I finally got a female again, and she doesn't have the hidden ability. I cry. Well, looks like we're going to be going for another like 60 more attempts. Okay, so thankfully it only took me a few more attempts to get another female. Finally, she has solar power and timid, so we're going to name her, let's go, hidden ability and nature. So just to let you guys know, that took me like 60 attempts to get what I needed. So now that I'm done with that, I'll put that Everstone back in there. I'm going to go ahead and get this nature and hidden ability up here. So I'm going to put Timid back up here. So hidden ability, I'll set her up here. So we have male and a female with hidden ability, male and a female Timid. I can get rid of those two guys because I didn't need them. And the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to breed this hidden ability nature with this Enormous and trying to get a giant Pokemon. Okay, based off what we have now, if we take a look here, we have a huge Pokemon. So, in between the enormous and huge, we have giant. So we have huge, giant, enormous, ginormous. So we're going to try to upgrade this female, and we're going to need to make her bigger in order for us to be able to get the ginormous size that we want. So let's go ahead and try to breed these guys a couple of times so we can get a female that has a bigger size. So we got a female. And she's enormous. Wow. Okay. So we got extremely lucky there. So we got enormous. So we, on the first try, got solar power. We've got timid. And we've got enormous. So now we can go ahead and name this bad girl. We have hidden ability. We have nature and size. So now if we breed, we can change this. So we can put this hidden ability female back in there. Or hidden ability nature female. And what we can do is we can breed these two guys together, and that has a possibility of breeding a ginormous egg. So let's take a look. So we got solar power, giant, and timid. So not him, but let's go ahead and give it another shot. Ooh, that's not what I meant to do. Let's take a look. Come on. We have solar power, giant, and timid. Come on. It's a 1 out of 3 chance, so third time's the charm. And let's see. Ginormous, timid, and solar power. So now we have all the stuff that we're looking for. We have our Charmander. We have ginormous size. We have the nature. We have the ball type we can work on because it's a 50-50 chance. Somehow we got a bunch of Ultra Balls in a row. So that's... not 50-50, it seems like. But then we have the hidden ability. So now what we're going to do, we have hidden ability. We have nature. We have size. And that's all that we need for him, right? Size, nature, hidden ability. Yep. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this bad boy. We're going to set him to the side. We can take this female here, get this Everstone off of her. Because this bad boy has the true size, the ginormous. So we're going to put him away. We can put these guys in the trash because we don't need them because they're not beneficial to our process at all. The next thing that we're going to want to do is start breeding our Pixelmon that have the perfect IVs so that we can actually get the perfect stat portion of, you know, the perfect Pixelmon done. So what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to try to get as many of these stats on one Pokemon as possible. And how I'm going to do that is I'm going to prioritize stats. So as I talked about earlier, for Charmander, it's not required for him to have perfect attack for him to be considered a perfect Pokemon because he doesn't utilize the attack stat at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to breed these two Pokemon here. So we have special defense and speed. So I'm going to run over here. I'm going to grab my power anklet and my power band. And I'm going to put it on the two Pokemon that it corresponds with so that they can pass down those stats. So I'm going to put these two in there. And what this should do is this should produce an Ospring that has perfect special defense and perfect speed. So that did in fact happen. But I don't want to use that because it also has perfect defense in there. And I don't want to skip steps to make it seem a little bit easier than it might be because I want to go all the way. So I'm going to go ahead and try to get another one real quick. So that one, it now has special defense and speed. So I'm going to go ahead and hatch it as well. So now I have a male. It has perfect special defense and speed. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these two power items off my Pixelmon. I'm going to put these two guys right here away because I don't need them now. So I can put him here. Now I'm going to do special attack and perfect defense. And I'm going to need to get my power lens and my power belt. And I'm going to put my power lens on my special attack and my power belt on my defense because those are the corresponding stats. So I'm going to go ahead and put these two in here. And now what I'm looking for or prioritizing is the possibility of a female, which I just got really lucky with. And let's go ahead and check her stats. So IV's 4. So she has perfect defense and perfect special attack. So now we're going to name her defense special attack. So now what we're going to want to do is we're going to breed this girl with this guy to try to get four perfect stats. So now I can take these power items off these two. Organize that up a little bit because I'm OCD. So I can put these guys back. And now we're going to start breeding these guys. So what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to put a power anklet on this one so that the speed is always guaranteed. I'm going to run over here and grab a destiny knot. And what that does is, as I explained earlier, the destiny knot allows for up to 5 stats of the parent's 12 total stats to be passed down. So with the power anklet, it'll guarantee the speed will be passed down. And then there's a possibility that the other 4 stats could be passed down. So now what we're looking for is an upgrade. So we need to get a female that has perfect defense, perfect special attack, and one of the stats from the father. Or we're looking to get the father that has perfect defense, perfect speed, and one of the stats from the mother. So we can't replace, like, the father with a male that doesn't have both of these stats and an additional one from the mother. And we can't replace the mother with a Pokemon that doesn't have at least special defense, with at least defense, special attack, and one of the stats from the father, because that would not be considered an upgrade if we don't have at least the same stats of the mother plus. So, we're going to go ahead and start breeding these guys until we can get an upgrade. That didn't take very long, so we got speed, defense, and special defense. So the father is the one that has special defense and speed, and hopefully if we hatch this, it's a male, which it is. So since it's a male, it now has defense, special defense, and speed. So we have defense, special defense, and speed. Now I can replace the father because this male is better than this male because it has the same 2 stats plus a stat. So now I can start breeding this guy and this girl in hopes that they produce a better egg. So now I don't need this one anymore. I'll put him away and let's see what we get. So we have a male that has, what did I type? 55. Of course I did. So there's no upgrade there. And we're going to proceed until we get another upgrade. All right, so we have defense, special attack, and speed. So if this egg happens to be a female, then it would be an upgrade. Oh my gosh, I got super lucky again. And it definitely was a female. So now I have defense, special attack, and speed. So let me go ahead and name her. Defense, special attack, and speed. So now I can remove that, put that on her. So this one right here isn't needed. This one right here we just upgraded from. So now we have 3 stats on each of these guys. And we need to get special attack on a male, or we need to get special defense on a female with the stats that we already have. So let's keep going until we can get 4 stats on one of these bad boys. All right, so we finally just got another egg that could be a potential upgrade. And it's not a potential upgrade. It is an upgrade because it's an egg that has all 4 of the stats that we need. So we just got a male that has perfect defense, special attack, special defense, and speed. So now we have a male that has all 4 perfect stats that we need. Now we're going to be looking to breed these two. So we have a male with 4 perfect stats, and now we have these 2 stats left. So we're going to breed perfect HP and perfect attack, and what we're going to try to do is get a female that has perfect HP and perfect attack so that we can breed it with this male that has the 4 remaining stats. So I'm going to go ahead and take this destiny knot off of this one. I'm going to go ahead and put this power anklet down. And we're going to go ahead and grab the last 2 power items that we need real quick. The power wave for HP, power bracer for attack. I'm going to go ahead and put these ones away because I don't need them. I'm going to go ahead and get HP and attack. So I'm going to put that weight on HP. And then we're going to go ahead and put the bracer on attack. So now, all we're looking to do... What did I do? Oop, wrong one. So we can do IVs. So that one... All right, just wanted to make sure it's not one that I needed. So I'm going to go ahead and breed these two guys now. And let's take a look. So it has both the stats that we need. We just need it to be a female, which it was. I'm getting remarkably lucky now because earlier I certainly wasn't. So what we're going to do is we're going to name this one Perfect. Well, we don't need to put Perfect. So we're going to put HP and Attack. So now we're going to go ahead and take these two off of there. And we can put these guys away. And now we're going to want to breed these two. So we're going to want HP and Attack with all of these guys. So what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to put Destiny Knot on the male. And then out of HP and Attack, Attack is the stat that we don't need for it to be considered a perfect Pokemon for Charizard because he doesn't utilize the attack stat. So I want HP to get passed down as a guarantee between these guys. But we also want Attack in there because it could still continue... It could still potentially be considered an upgrade because if we get a male that has 5 perfect IVs, we can still use this female that has 2 to try to help increase our odds. So now we're going to breed these two in hopes that we can get an upgrade from either of them. All right, so we finally got an upgrade for one of the ones that we need, and it is our Pokemon that has HP, Defense, Special Attack, Special Defense, and Speed. So that would be considered a battle perfect Charmander because, again, attack is not necessary. So now that we do have that, what we're going to do real quick is we're going to go ahead and name this bad boy Battle Perfect, and we're going to go ahead and move this Destiny Knot to him. Let me go ahead and pick it back up, put the Destiny Knot on him. We can retire the male that we do have and put him away. So after evaluating a little bit, I determined it's going to be a lot easier to go about it a different way. So I have this Battle Perfect male, and I was trying to get a female that was Battle Perfect so I could breed it with the hidden ability, nature, and size male that I have, but it's a lot easier to get a female of this than it is a female of this because there's 5 stats that go into it, so there's way more RNG than this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this male and this female, and I'm going to breed these until I have a female that's ginormous with hidden ability and the nature. So I'm going to breed these few guys. I'm going to breed these guys a few times, and I'm going to put the Everstone on either one of them. It doesn't matter because they have the same nature, and I'm going to breed them until I get the female that I need. Okay, so just to evaluate now, what had occurred is I was able to get a female that has the solar power ability. It's timid and is ginormous, but... my audio stopped working because I went to have dinner, and when I came back, apparently my mic got unplugged somehow, so I'm just reevaluating and informing you guys what had occurred so that you're up to speed. So I'm going to go ahead and put the Everstone on this female because she's going to be what we're using now, so we can put these bad boys away. And now we're going to want this Battle Perfect male and this female here, and we're going to go ahead and try to breed these guys so that we can get an upgrade. What we're going to want to do is to try to get an upgrade for the female. So we're going to go ahead and breed these guys, and we're going to go until we get a female, and we're going to want to make sure that we have that Destiny Knot on them. And I'm going to need more of these golden hourglasses. So we just need to go until we get an upgrade for the female because we can't replace the male because the male doesn't have the ability to pass down that hidden ability. Plus, the male's already a battle perfect. So the female, it's going to be a lot easier to get an upgrade for than the male because the RNG required to get an upgrade for the male would be crazy. Alright, so we got a female. Solar power. Timid. It's huge. It's not ginormous, but I just realized it's going to be very difficult because the male that we have is probably going to be pretty small. So the male we have is small, so we're going to have to worry about the size towards a later portion. So let's look at the IVs real quick. So it's got perfect defense. So we have defense. So we're going to want to go ahead and swap this out. And we're going to want to keep this female because this female is really good. We're going to want to get rid of this one, and now we're going to want to use these guys. And we're trying to get a female with more perfect IVs. All right, so we just got a female that is small, which is not good, but it's got more of the other stuff that we need. So it's got perfect speed, perfect special defense, and HP. So I'm going to do HP, special defense, and speed. So let's take a look. Yep, all right, so that's what we need. So we're going to go ahead, get rid of these guys. So it took a while to get a female that had solar power as an upgrade. So now I'm going to use him. And we're abandoning the size for now, because we're going to have to try to get better stats across the board before we can worry about the size again. Because solar power, it's going to be hard to do anything unless we have a battle perfect female with like solar power, because solar power is what's causing the complications here. So now we're just going to go again until we can get an upgrade for the female. All right, so I finally got an upgrade. So I had to take a break and came back to it because it took me a while and I still hadn't gotten a female as an upgrade. So now I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these two males because I don't need them. I'm going to go ahead and pass this to this female, and I'm going to start using this female as a replacement. And it also, I got a bigger size for it. So it was a bit of an upgrade because of the size as well. So now we're going to continue. And the only thing I need to get is special attack on a female, and I'll have a battle perfect female. Okay, so I finally got an upgrade for the male. So this is a male with solar power that's timid. And it's actually giant, so it's a bit bigger than what it's not a bit bigger, it's a few sizes bigger than what the previous one was. And it also has solar power, so we can get rid of this male and put this male here. And we're going to go ahead and throw this battle perfect guy in here. We don't need him. We don't need him. So now we're trying to get back up to our size that we need, or a battle perfect female. Alright, so I just hatched two more eggs. So I got a male and a female, and I just got the best possible outcome I could potentially have. So this one here, if we look at IVs 5, it's got perfect HP, defense, special attack, special defense, and speed. So it's battle perfect, and if we take a look at it, it's got solar power, it's timid, and it's enormous. So we're getting back up to our size, and it's a battle perfect female. So we can go ahead, put this Everstone on this female. Now we have two battle perfects, and now what we're trying to do is we're trying to get the male size back up because he's giant, so we need to get him to either enormous or ginormous, and then we're also missing that last stat for it to be considered a perfect. So we can go ahead and get rid of these guys, and now we're going to go until we get an upgrade. All right, guys, so I'm having a little bit of technical issues. My microphone keeps stopping from recording for some reason, and so I'm just going to break down what exactly occurred. So we were breeding this perfect battle perfect male and this battle perfect female, and we got another battle perfect female that's ginormous, and then we had another male that was exactly the same as what we had. It was a giant status, so got rid of that male because it's not needed. Just put the Everstone on the ginormous female because we're going to start using her to breed. So technically, if we were to take a look at her, she's got her solar power, she's got her timid nature, she's got her IV, so she's our Charmander. She's got our size that we want, the ginormous. She's got her nature, which is timid. She has her ball type, which is a Pokeball, because along the breeding lines, it's a 50-50 between the parents, and most of them were caught with a Pokeball. So eventually, I ended up getting the Pokeball, and I have the hidden ability. So the only thing I'm missing to get a 100% perfect Pokemon is the attack stat. And that attack stat is completely random. So it has a 1 out of 31% chance of being a 31, obviously. So we just have to get lucky and hope that what we're, you know, trying to get happens. So from here, the only upgrade that we could potentially get is a size upgrade for the Battle Perfect male, and then a 100%. And that's what we're going to be going for, so I'll be back with you when that happens. Boom. We just got a size upgrade for our male. So we have solar power, timid, ginormous. And if we were looking at his IVs, he is a battle perfect. So what we're going to do is we're going to swap him. So now we have two ginormous Pokemon going to be breeding to get our ginormous 100%. So now the only thing that we can do in order to upgrade from here is to get 100% with the stats that we need. Okay, and there you have it, folks. So after a long time, I almost ran out of another stack of golden hourglasses. So we have our Charmander. Solar power, timid, ginormous. He's in a Pokeball, and if we take a look at his IVs, 100%. So now that we'd have him as 100%, the only thing that you'd be able to do is to continue to use him to try to breed more with the female that you have. After all those upgrades and all that time we just spent and all the time you just spent watching this video, I greatly appreciate your patience, especially because it's taken me a lot longer to put this video out there than I was expecting. Special shout out to a new subscriber that recently tuned in on a live stream last night that was asking about any upcoming Pixelmon videos. It motivated me to get out here and finally finish this up so I can provide it to you guys so that you have this content to use to make your new 100% perfect IV Pixelmon with all the bells and whistles that you're intending for it to have. So now that we made the best possible Charmander that we can, my job here is done. I thank you guys for watching, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. Take it easy and peace.